musical legend is someone who, with their unique talent, integrates themselves to the history and life of an entire community, and whose music continues to live on through the years from generation to generation. Benny More is more than just a legend. His songs including Que Bueno Baila Usted, Como Fue, Francisco Guayabal, and Bonito y Sabroso have transmitted hundreds of emotions that for decades clearly identified Cuban culture. Inspired by the work of this legend, another musical icon of Cuban origin, Grammy Award winner John Tejada, with more than 20 million albums sold throughout the world, lays a deserved tribute to Benny More.
Well, I think that's what this project, what community can bring to the table is, first and foremost, a discovery of the ones that might not even know who Benny More was. Bring it to a place where you understand the magic, the magistry of really what he did.
The performance factor, as employed by Benny More, was consubstantial with his art, and it was almost impossible to dance to Benny's music without falling to the temptation of observing what he was simultaneously doing on stage.
El público que él tenía era un público que se acercaba a la tarima, y en la tarima, en la parte de adelante, no podía nadie bailar, porque todo era para ver los movimientos que él hacía y todas las acciones que él hacía y cómo dirigía la orquesta.
I mean, he's great on records, but in person, he's even better.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's incredible.
Yeah, definitely. And he won the crowd over because he's very, very showmanship, very agitated, you know, his body language.
Right.
Put everybody to, like, really have a good time.
Aside from his innate musical feeling, he was gifted with a fluid tenor that colored and phrased with great expressiveness. For him, an instant could seem like an eternity, and his capability of expressing in a song, a gesture, and a scream, innumerable centuries of pain, rootlessness, slavery, hope, and love.
Alma mía, que te hace. Benny era una persona que le transmitía humanidad a la persona, enseñaba a querer al público. Las personas, cuando él llegaba a los bailes, se le acercaban y era pidiéndole dinero para una medicina, una receta. Casi todo el mundo tenía una receta que darle. Decía, pero yo no sé a este hombre. Entonces parece que tenía nominaciones de billetes en distintos lugares. Metía la mano, miraba la cara a la persona. Parece que ya conocía si era verdad o no era verdad. Entonces le daba dinero.
A él no le gustaba que lo regañaran, porque cuando la familia decía, tú das mucho dinero a la gente, y no le gustaba. ¿Te cuenta cómo es? Él daba dinero porque la gente iba, vende, mira, por favor, para alquiler, vende, que se yo, y que se jugando, ¿cuánto te hace falta? Le decía, ven acá, niña, tráeme la cartera, una cartera roja. Le daba 100 pesos. ¿Te basta cómo es? Sí, que te basta cómo es.
¿Qué te hace pensar que no te quiero? Si tu amor es la fuente que me inspira a vivir y sentirme tan feliz, tan feliz.
Benny was capable of dictating to his arrangers what he imagined with a fabulous sense of harmony, timbre, and rhythm.
Tenía una musicalidad impresionante, donde él todo lo decía, bueno, hágame esto y todo caía bien, como si fuera un arreglo en el momento ahí.
Quien no lo estudia, él no sabe lo que es música. Él hay que estudiarlo todos los días. Es una escuela distinta.
Te fuiste de mi vida.
He came to New York around 1958-59, and to the Palladium Ballroom. It's just a one-nighter.
Right.
And he rehearsed the band with us, his music. And I remember most of his arrangement was just little pieces of paper that he would ad-lib to the band, give the cues to the band. Give the instructions to the rhythm section. When this part comes in, I want the rhythm section to play this.
Mm-hmm.
listen to Benny, the complexity of the songs, mm-hmm. attached to the timbre of his voice, mm-hmm. his phrasing. Mm-hmm. He was a tremendous singer, and I at the same time you understand how he was so historically so important for the style mm-hmm. Of his song, of course, but eventually what became the modern style of tropical singing.
Always very happy. He's a happy individual. Always joking with the Cuban guys in the band. It was Machito and his Afro-Cubans, and he had a special rapport with Mario Bauza and Machito, and René Hernández, the pianist arranger. So they were having a good time together. Director of of the rehearsal and of his recordings.
Wow. Mm.
And it was very musical.
You know, Benny Ford just had a tremendous sense of music, of melody, and to know exactly what he wanted to do, and you hear it in these arrangements.
Benny was a member of the famous Trio Matamoros, with whom he traveled to Mexico in June of 1945. And where he performed at the famous cabarets of the time and created various recordings together with Mariano Marcerón and the great Damaso Pérez Prado.
And he started out originally with the Trio Matamoros. They went to Mexico and they wanted an extra singer.
Okay.
So they took Benny with them, and then he stayed in Mexico.
Even though the Conjunto Matamoros returned to Havana, More remained in Mexico, and it was there that he acquired his artistic name.
Benny. More era Maximiliano More Benítez. El nombre de él. Entonces nosotros desde muchachos juntos jugábamos familia. Después el único tiempo que estuvimos separados fueron 5 años, cuando él se fue en el año 45 con Matamoros para allá para México. Por haberte
amando. At the end of 1950, Benny returned to Cuba as an international star throughout Latin America, including Mexico, Panama, Colombia, Brazil, and Puerto Rico.
They actually started working with Benny More when he was recording Pérez Prado's work. Mambo No. 5 was also published by Pure Music.
Wow.
And that's how they hooked up with him, realized he had some songwriting talent. And in 1952, after he'd been working in Mexico with Pérez Prado, he signed to our office in Havana as an exclusive songwriter.
It was there that Benny became founder of Benny More's gigantic band, composed of more than 40 musicians, and was immensely popular not only in Cuba, but also in Venezuela, Jamaica, Haiti, Colombia, Panama, Mexico, and the United States.
One of the reasons he signed with Pure is because they had offices around the world and he knew he'd get representation and promotion all around the world.
Right.
And it's great to say that even today, we're still working on promoting his music.
Esta noche a las 9 y 15 minutos dejó de existir en el Instituto Nacional de Cirugía, antiguo hospital de emergencia, Benny Moré, uno de los más grandes ídolos artísticos del pueblo de Cuba en todas sus épocas. La muerte del popular autor...
On February 19, 1963, the whole world mourned when El Bárbaro del Ritmo died in Cuba.
Un dolor... Ni un desengaño.
El último baile fue en Palmira. Ahí fue donde él se empezó, se agravó. Y esa noche, le puedo decir que esa noche cantó como nunca. Para mí que fue la mejor noche, la mejor actuación que hizo Benny Moré. Incluso hasta los micrófonos se echaron a perder. Usted sabe que él tenía 21 músicos. Quitó el micrófono de él y se oía por arriba de toda la orquesta.
Francisco Guayabal, Francisco Guayabal, mujeres de San Francisco, vengan todas a bailar.
¿Cómo fue? No sé decirte. ¿Cómo fue? No sé explicarme. ¿Qué pasó? Pero de ti me enamoré.
Como Fue is probably the most recognized Benny Moré song, like you said, maestro, across the board, internationally. So, that's his anthem.
Fue una luz que iluminó todo mi ser. Risa como un manantial, lleno mi vida de inquietud.
And actually, we, with that particular song, we're going to do it as a duet with Benny.
So,
Gonna get the original master, and then John's going to sing a duet with Benny on that one.
Yeah.
It's gonna be very fun to record because the way that I want to do it is in a live setting, in a sense that we're gonna be in a studio, but we're gonna have actually the entire band in the studio, and John's gonna be there as well. Peter and I went to Puerto Rico to talk to Charlie Sepulveda, the trumpet player. And Charlie's got a phenomenal big band, and you know, they play a lot. They're playing like at La Concha Hotel in Puerto Rico. They play pretty much about every week. And I remember I went to talk to Charlie, and I told him a little bit about the project, and Charlie told me, he said, you know, you gotta get to arrange this. Is Rey Santos. And immediately when he said Rey Santos and all the albums that I know that that I've heard that that the maestro has been associated with, you know, they came to mind, and I said, of course, that's, you know, he would be perfect.
John Zacata's tribute to Benny Moré fulfills his lifelong dream of paying tribute to his hero and assuming the challenge of interpreting Benny's classic songs in their original keys. An important musical component of this innovative project is the participation of Charlie Sepulveda and his San Juan Big Band, one of the few big bands active in the contemporary tropical music scene.
Pues Benny Moré pues significa mucho, porque uno es fanático. Yo no soy de la época, no, naturalmente de la época de Benny, pero sí. He escuchado su música y yo sé lo importante porque estamos hablando de uno de los artistas más queridos de Cuba, uno de los querendones. Cuando Julio me llamó para el proyecto, yo me reí, yo dije, Julio, ¿tú estás en serio? Le dije, Julio, tú estás medio loco, pero usted, pues yo sé que estamos todos locos. Y me dijo, ¿en serio? Ya yo hablé con John y eso. Yo le dije, pero él no, ni me conoce. Sí, él sabe quién tú eres. Pues yo, pues imagínate, me puse súper contento. Porque yo sé lo grande. O sea, estamos hablando de un superestrella que ha vendido sobre un montón de millones de copias de discos y eso. Y yo soy pues, el trompetista del barrio, ya tú sabes. Me siento muy contento. Primero, que se esté haciendo Puerto Rico. Que se esté haciendo Puerto Rico, pues... Yo sé que pudieron coger diferentes estudios, como irse a Los Ángeles, ir a grabarlo a Miami, ir a Nueva York, y que hayan escogido mi orquesta, pues me siento muy honrado.
Musical arrangements were completed in New York by the maestro Rey Santos, who had also created arrangements for Benny himself.
It's a pleasure for an arranger to work with that harmonic structure because it gives you a chance to really make the orchestra sound very paired with the singer.
Fueron tus ojos o tu boca.
The recording of this album was completed in Puerto Rico and was produced by five-time Latin Grammy-nominated producer Julio Bagge.
It's really exciting to have the opportunity to have new recordings of these works.
Yes.
These are such classic pieces of music.
John Segada's To Benny With Love will be an album that will keep Benny More's music alive for generations to come.
Explicarme qué pasó, pero de ti me enamoré. Fue una luz que iluminó todo mi ser. Tu risa como un manantial regó mi vida de inquietud. Explicarme qué pasó, pero de ti me enamoré. Thank you.
sé, más no sé, no sé decirte cómo fue.
No sé explicarme qué pasó, pero de ti
me enamoré,
me enamoré.
Y viene llorando, pidiendo perdón. Pero hay rebeldía en mi corazón.